Hi, Inonga here. Welcome to my first quickfire video. I'm talking about some practicalities of prayer. So I just kind of want to highlight three things. Firstly, how to pray. Secondly, when to pray. And then thirdly, what to pray for. So how to pray. There's so many things that I could say about this, but I just want to highlight the fact that we have access to God as Father, and we're praying to a God who is Father. And so that means the way you pray, you're not kind of terrified. You're praying to a God who you know you're going to be listened to. So don't pray as if, Lord, if you possibly could hear me, maybe just he does hear you. So praying confidently that you will be heard. Secondly, praying in line with God's character, in line with who God is. And that means, you know, maybe praising God for what he's done, praising God for who he is, and praying in light of that, praying according to God's will. There's things that are revealed in scripture that we know are God's will. So praying for God's purposes to be fulfilled in our lives, in the lives of other people as well. And those are just some helpful ways that we can pray. And scripture has a lot, and I've put a few in the description of tools that you can use to pray, kind of prayer patterns that you can use to shape your own prayers. Things like, you know, thanksgiving and praise and petition and supplication and intercession and that kind of thing. So that's the first area in terms of how do I pray? When do I pray? You know, people say all sorts of things. You should set time apart. You should be praying all the time. You should pray, you know, with other people. And I think all these are true. And I think a balance in having all of this at some point in your life is really helpful. So, for example, pray continually. That's just like, you know, you're at work and somebody asks a question and you're like, I don't know how to answer that. Pray. You overhear a conversation that somebody's having on the street, they're sharing the gospel with somebody, you're encouraged rather than just being like, oh, that's nice, isn't it great, that's so bold, pray. And I do that very regularly, usually when I'm on my way to training for the football and I'm going to be doing my role as a chaplain and I'm shattered, I really don't want to be there. I pray for energy, I pray for strength. And saying, God, you know, use me how you want to use me. Help me to listen well. Help me to love these girls. So I pray, you know, as I'm walking to the pitch. I pray as I'm on the pitch, say if I'm having a conversation or somebody looks injured, somebody doesn't look quite right. You know, praying for discernment, praying for wisdom, praying for opportunities, praying. So that's what I mean by kind of praying continually. Just prayer being something that's like normal and like asking for help in day-to-day things, in normal everyday life. But then also it's important, I think, to set time apart. And a helpful way of doing this is when you're studying the Bible and using that time to pray as well, praying about what you've learned, praying that, you know, that would shape and mold your life. But also just, you know, set time apart so that you're able to pray specifically about things. You might not be able to do that when you're, you know, sort of driving or when you're walking somewhere, but when you've got that time set apart, you can kind of slow down, ponder things and think things through and pray specifically for them. And then pray corporately as well. This one is one that kind of get left out because, you know, you go to a prayer meeting and it's a bit underwhelming. You're like, is this really working? It's amazing praying with God's people. So going to church prayer meeting, I know it's the one thing that I'm, you know, prone to cutting out of my life. I'm busy. I just won't do the corporate prayer, but I find it really helpful. Listening to other people praying with them. You are a church body, you're part of the body of Christ. And so praying with other Christians and other believers is something really, really powerful and something that scripture is full of examples of people praying together and God using that to bring about his purposes. So remember to pray corporately as well. Okay, so how do you pray? When do you pray? What do you pray for? This is, you know, there's so many things you could pray for. And I think if you don't have an idea of where you're going with your prayer, it can just become all over the place. Or you kind of pray for the same things all the time and it comes a bit dull. So I find it helpful. I've got a whiteboard where I've got days, right? I've got days and I allocate things to pray for. Because there's certain things, if I don't write them down, I'll never pray for them. So I pray, for example, for my church family. I pray for the people in my community group. I pray for the elders in my church and the pastor of our church. And that's an important thing. I mean, the devil isn't rolling out a red carpet like, oh, you're preaching God's word. That's nice. He's going to attack him. He's going to attack those men, their families, you know. And just really important to pray for your church and church leadership. So I allocate time to do that because otherwise I would forget to do that. I pray for friends, right? This is something like you might forget to pray for. You just, they're fine, they're great. And you're like, oh, it's great, I've got these friends. But praying for them, pray you know, amazing things for your friends. Things like, you know, the passages in Colossians where that they'll be filled with the wisdom of God if they're Christians. If they're not Christians, pray that they would come to know Christ. So praying prayers for your friends that are actually grounded in scripture and wanting them to grow in holiness and knowing God better, that kind of thing. You know, and there's so many examples, family or whatever. But also one thing that you might forget to pray for is your nation, praying for your leaders, praying for global things. A really important principle is that God uses the prayers of his people to bring about his purposes in the world. And so those kind of prayers, you might think, well, I'm praying for something happening somewhere really far away and it's really far removed from me. But it's really, really helpful. I think just understanding the bigger picture that God is using your prayer to bring about his purposes. And so get one of those, you know, diaries that you can get you know, it tells you different things going on in the world, or maybe if you've got missionaries in your church, you know, any kind of connection that you can find and use that to pray. Helpful tools that I think might be useful. You know, the whiteboard, you can use that. You don't have to use it. You can have a prayer journal, prayer diary of some kind. I find it helpful to actually, I don't always do this, but to write down prayers. I looked at my prayer book, diary, whatever you call it, from like 7 years ago. And some of the things that I was stressing about, just like, isn't it amazing that God brought me through that? And some of the things that I prayed for, they're still on the prayer list. And, you know, it reminds me, you know, to keep those priorities and to keep praying, but also answered prayer. And it reminds me to be grateful and to remember that, you know, God does actually listen and to continue to persevere in prayer. So those are just some of the things that I think practically are helpful in terms of praying. One important thing to remember is the Spirit's role in our praying. Like, it's not something that we just kind of conjure up our energy. Of course, we do set time aside, but praying that the Spirit would, you know, intercede on our behalf, and praying that the Spirit would use God's word. So if you're praying using scripture, that God's word would speak to us, because that's how God speaks to us in prayer. It's through his word. And so understanding that and understanding that the Spirit actually comforts us. And when we're not sure what to pray, the Spirit actually intercedes for us. And so praying in the Spirit is praying in line with God's word. It's being rooted in God's word and in scripture. So that's something really important as well. So I hope that's helpful. And check out the description where I flesh out some of these things. And then just pray. Start now.